السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا. فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him because He is worthy of praise. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the evils within ourselves and the evil consequences of our actions. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessings upon the last and final messenger, His family, His companions, His wives, and all those who follow His way until the end of time. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. We remind one another to be people of taqwa, to be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we ask Allah to make us among the muttaqeen. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz radiyallahu ta'ala an is known as, and rightfully so, as one of the khulafa al-rashideen, the rightly guided khulafa. And his time as a khalifa, as a political leader, was a mere 2 years, a short 2 years. Yet in those 2 years, he was able to enact an amount of justice that remains a type of amazing and astonishing accomplishment even till this day. He was so known for his justice that even his political opponents from the Romans and beyond would praise him and would acknowledge the extent of his justice. He was a righteous man to the testimony of all Muslims. Yet when we look at the life of Umar ibn Abd al-Aziz, what we see is a man who was constantly concerned over his standing and his position in front of Allah. He would go to sleep, as his wife describes, Fatima, rahimahullah. He would go to sleep with tears in his eyes. Literally, he would cry himself to sleep, constantly repeating the verse, Fariqun fil Jannah wa Fariqun fil Sa'ir. A portion of humanity is in paradise and a portion of humanity is in hellfire. And he's crying because he considered himself as possibly being among the portion of the hellfire. Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, or his wife Fatima rahimahullah, would try and nourish and support her stress-filled husband by telling him, you can do this, you have the power to do that, there's nothing wrong with doing that. And he would respond and say, you're right, I do have the power to do that. وَلَكِنِّي أَخَافُ اللَّهِ. However, I'm afraid of Allah. I'm afraid if I do something wrong, Allah will hold me accountable. This man, his last words that he uttered before passing away was the verse in Surah Al-Qasas, تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةُ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Translated as, the afterlife, paradise, is a home for those who don't seek supremacy on earth and they don't cause mischief on earth. And the end result is in favor of the people of taqwa who act in accordance to what please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Throughout all of human history, there is always an ism, an ideology of movement that seeks to centralize one group of people as being inherently superior to others, and that justifies their crimes against those other people. In our time, we call it nationalism, that we, because we are of a certain nation, that makes us inherently, fundamentally superior to another people. Or some people view their gender as being superior to the other gender, or that their economic situation is superior to another, or that their lineage or their tribe is better than another. And what that ends up leading to is a type of impunity, a justification for oppressing other people. And the worst of these kinds of supremacies is when it's a religious supremacy, a supremacy that is rooted in supposed religious arguments. And you have this terrorist organization called Netanyahu and his ilk, who constantly, in their propaganda, to justify their crimes against the Palestinian people, say, we're the chosen people, we're the chosen people, we're God's chosen people. And you have the evangelicals of America, who in their mega churches promote this stuff. They're God's chosen people. God promised them that land. And what you have is what you see: crimes against humanity. But let it be very clear that the Quran is explicit in letting every single human being know that Allah doesn't play favorites. Do you really think, O Christians or Jews or Muslims, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is of a certain skin color, is of a certain hair color, is of a certain gender, that He looks at humanity and saying, I prefer these over others? Do you honestly think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prefers some people over another because of inherently unchosen features that we have no choice in? Do you really see God that way? And if you do, you have a distorted reality of who Allah is. Allah doesn't play favorites. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bluntly, explicitly tells the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, He tells the most beloved creation, not human being, the most beloved creation to Him. He says to the Prophet point blank, لَإِنْ أَشْرَكْتَ لَيَحْبَطَنَّ عَمَلُكَ وَلَتَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ He says, Ya Rasulullah, if you dare worship other than me, I will nullify all that you have done and I'll make you of the losers. To the Prophet, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he also tells the Prophet, وَلَوْ تَقَوَّلَ عَلَيْنَا بَعْضَ الْأَقَاوِيلِ لَأَخَذْنَا مِنْهُ بِالْيَمِينِ ثُمَّ لَقَطَعْنَا مِنْهُ الْوَتِينِ فَمَا مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ عَنْهُ حَاجِزِينَ Allah tells us that if the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام dare fabricate a lie against Allah, then Allah would cut his veins so that blood is no longer able to be pumped from his heart to the rest of his body, and nobody would be able to protect him from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And he tells the Muslims, مَنْ يَرْتَدَّ مِنْكُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ فَسَوْفَ يَأْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ If you leave this religion, no problem. Allah will replace you with somebody else. In other words, if you are currently enjoying the favors of Allah, if you leave Allah's obedience, if you leave Allah's religion, then you are no longer chosen. You are no longer of value to Allah. You are no longer in His favor. Allah doesn't play favorites. So let it be known to every Muslim, Christian, and Jew, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't prefer somebody over somebody else because of their skin color, because of their ethnicity. It's irrelevant to Allah. Rather, it is our actions. It is our actions. So Allah does not play favorites, O Netanyahu, so stop fabricating lies. Allah doesn't play favorites, O evangelicals, so stop fabricating lies against God. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refutes the people of the book and their claim to this type of chosenness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ وَالنَّصَارَ نَحْنُ أَبْنَاءُ اللَّهِ وَأَحِبَّاءُ The Jews and Christians, they claim we are the children of God and we are beloved to God. We're chosen. And Allah responds, قُلْ فَلِمَ يُعَذِّبُكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ Why does He punish you then? If you're so favorite to God, if you're so chosen, why does He punish you? And then Allah continues and says and makes it clear, بَلْ أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ مِّمَّنْ خَلَقٍ You're a human being, like any other human being. Allah created you as He created every single other human being. And Allah then says, He is the King. He is the sovereign. Everything is under his control. He forgives whom he wills and he punishes whom he wills. He is God, Lord of the universe. He doesn't play favorites. Subhanahu min ilah. So don't come with to us with this propaganda that is only meant to justify your tyranny and your crimes and your ugliness. For if you think you were once chosen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can throw you in the trash can of history in an instant. Allah doesn't play favorites. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made tazkiyah of the self haram, a major sin. Tazkiyah of the self is when a person claims to be beloved to God, claims to be valuable in front of God, claims that God sees him or her as righteous. Allah has made that not only haram, a major sin. And once again, talking to the Christians and the Jews, and of course to Muslims in extension, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِينَ يُزَكُّونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ. Have you seen these people who do tazkiyah of the self? They claim to be righteous. They claim that God, that Allah loves them. They claim that they're righteous people. Allah, does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, بَلِ اللَّهُ يُزَكِّي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah determines who's righteous. It is Allah's favor. If you are a righteous person, truly a righteous person, that is Allah who puts you, put righteousness in your heart. And this is precisely what Umar ibn Abdul Aziz understood. If I am good, it is from Allah, nothing to boast about. And just because I am good and in Allah's favors today does not make me immune to sins and to faults. And does not guarantee that I will continue to be in God's favor over the course of history, or at least the course of my life. That's not the way it works. And then Allah continues and he says, انظر كيف يفترون على الله الكذب. Look at how they're lying about Allah. They make these claims. So we say unapologetically to these propagandists who want to justify the crimes against our Palestinian brothers and sisters, you, in your claim that you have the right to do what you do because you are supposedly God's chosen people, you are liars. And you are lying to God. And you will be held accountable to that. And just to be clear, we Muslims don't have the right to claim that we're chosen by God. And take Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala, his statement. Don't look down, don't be condescending even to a disbeliever. For perhaps Allah might guide that person to make him better or her better than you. And perhaps Allah might misguide you to where you become a disbeliever. It is Allah's kingdom. He rises, he causes to rise whom he wills, and he causes to fall whom he wills. So stop playing these games. Stop fabricating these lies against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who you claim to be in such servitude to. Rather, you are liars. Rather, we Muslims, we look to Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an, to be our role model, where he, during his khilafah, when he simultaneously brought down the Roman Empire and the Persian Empire, he would walk around Medina saying, Ana Uwaymir, I'm the small Umar, I'm the little Umar. When I was young, I used to clean the dung, the poop of the sheep. I used to hold it in my hand. That's who I am. Instead of saying, well, I'm so great and I'm so grand and I'm so superior, look at what I did. Radiallahu ta'ala an. And last but definitely not least, lineage means nothing to Allah. Whether you are from Ishaq, or you're from Ismail, or you are from whoever, it is meaningless to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it is actions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards or punishes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, talking to Ibrahim alayhi salam in conversation with Ibrahim, says, قَالَ إِنِّي جَاعِلُكَ لِلنَّاسِ إِمَامًا. Allah tells Ibrahim, I'm going to make you a leader, a role model for humanity. Ibrahim, in his excitement, responded and says, قَالَ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي. He asked the question, oh Allah, what about for my children? Allah responded and said, قَالَ لَا يَنَالُ عَهْدِ الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah said, that responsibility, that honor of religious leadership will not go down to your descendants who are unjust. Allah is telling Ibrahim, among your children will be those who are disbelievers, those who Allah despises, those who are the enemies of Allah. And he's telling this to Ibrahim, so don't come to us and say, just because you are of a certain lineage, that that matters or that means anything. Wasn't Nuh's son, alayhi salam, a disbeliever? And Allah told Nuh, alayhi salam, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ مِنْ أَهْلِكَ إِنَّهُ عَمَلٌ غَيْرُ صَالِحٌ. Your son is not of you. His actions were unjust, were unrighteous. Wasn't Ibrahim, alayhi salam's father, a disbeliever? An enemy of Allah? فَلَمَّا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ أَنَّهُ عَدُوٌ لِلَّهِ. He was the enemy of Allah. Yet Ibrahim is Khalil al-Rahman. He is the close friend of Allah. Lineage doesn't matter. It's irrelevant. It's meaningless. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse, وَبَارَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ وَعَلَىٰ إِسْحَاقِ وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِهِمَا مُحْسِنٌ وَظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ مُبِينٌ. Allah says, we blessed Ibrahim and Ishaq, and among their descendants are those who are good, those who are righteous, those who Allah loves. And among their descendants are those who are unjust, those who are disbelievers, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala despises. So don't come at us with your propaganda. You are liars against Allah. No human being is inherently better than another human being. That is what our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said. An Arab is not better than a non-Arab, and a non-Arab is not better than an Arab. A white person is not better than a black person, and a black person is not better than a white person. كُلُّكُمْ مُنْ آدَمْ and آدَمْ مِنْ تُرَابْ. All of us go back to Adam, alayhi salam, and all of us go back to dirt. So don't come at us with your supremacy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliate such individuals. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. Shame on every Muslim, Christian, or Jew who uses Allah's name, who uses the name of God to justify their violence and their tyranny. Shame on every single person who sees themselves as inherently better than another creation of Allah. Shame on any person who lies about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us that true love of Allah comes from servitude to Him, and that servitude is always infused with His names and His attributes, meaning with mercy, with wisdom, with kindness, and with compassion. And so anybody who's behaving to the contrary, in an opposite manner, then they are following the shaitan. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us help our brothers and sisters in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expose the lies and the crimes of this terrorist regime, Netanyahu and his ilk. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show us who's truly in charge, him, the king, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring peace, and may He bring stability to that region. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma aghfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'mineen wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibu da'awati ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to overlook our shortcomings, to accept our good deeds, and to increase us from His bounties. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa aqim as-salat.